Beautiful souls, I welcome you to my YouTube channel. And before you begin, if you like my video, like my channel, please like, share, subscribe and comment. And if you need any of my services, feel free to look in the description box below and click over the link. Okay, and yes, today's topic is am I under the effect of some kind of spell. Okay, this is a requested video, so I just thought to do a reading on that. And this is a general reading. It may or may not resonate with everybody. So take what resonates and leave the rest. Also, this is a timeless reading. So whenever you are drawn to this video and this reading, this message is meant for you. Okay? So yeah, let's begin. We'll be having 5 piles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number 1, we'll have this crown. Number 2, heart. Number 3, moon. I don't know if it looks like moon. Number 4, circle. Number 5, triangle. So you can pause the video, you can meditate, you can use a pendulum or any means to see which one draws you the most, which of these shapes draws you the most. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. Also, we'll be looking for any guidance for you if you are under the effect of spell. Okay. So we'll just begin. Pile number 1, who chose this crown? Let's see. Guides, please let me know. And yes, there are no reverse card readings today. Guides, please let me know. Are pile number 1 under the effect of some kind of spell? Master. So this is kind of the ascension card. Okay, so no, you are not under the effect of some spell. You are not. I don't see that. Okay, this is a very positive card. It speaks of spirituality, ascension, connection to the divine. So no, I don't see any kind of evil thing on you, evil spell on you. Okay, now let's pick a guidance card to see what you should do. I'm sorry, I just need to see. I'm back. So let's see the guidance card for you. What you need to do. Moment to moment. So I see you are quite cautious about it. This is why obviously you are looking into this reading. So don't be cautious. Okay, do not be how should I explain? Being cautious is okay, but do not be overly cautious. Like, do not doubt on everybody. Do not doubt on everybody, but do not blind trust either. There might be people around you who might try to manipulate you or use some kind of this kind of energy on you. So be cautious. It is good to be cautious, but it is not good to doubt on everybody, but because it might affect your mental health, emotional health adversely. Okay, so yeah, be cautious, but do not doubt on everybody. This is your guidance. Just trust your intuition, just trust your instinct, and share things only with trustworthy people. Do not share your things with everybody. Do not share your thoughts and your feelings with everybody. Okay, just with trustworthy people. Okay, so pile number 1, this was your reading. Let's move on to pile number 2. That is people who chose this heart. Is pile number 2 under the effect of some kind of spell? We'll put guidance also for you. Guidance for pile number 2. Guidance for pile number 2. Guidance for pile number 2. Guidance. Guidance for pile. Okay. ओके सो आर यू अंडर द इफेक्ट ऑफ सम स्पेल फ्लावरिंग नो डेफिनेटली नॉट In fact, you are surrounded by positive energies, I would say, just like pile number one. And what you need to do, we got the traveling card. So you just need to release the burden, I would say. Just trust on the path you are walking, okay? Release the burden and release the stress that you are under the effect of something. If there is any negative thing surrounding you, that is only your stress, okay? You are overburdened. Because there might be a difficult path ahead which you need to walk on. Okay? So just release that and yeah, just walk ahead. Just walk ahead, okay? There is nothing like some negative energy or negative spell. Okay? Just trust on your path. Okay? Pile number two, this was your reading. Let's move on to number three. This moon. What you're reading is pile number three under the effect of some spell. We got two cards, okay. Guidance for pile number three, spirits. Guidance for pile number three. We got the new vision card for you. And we got the existence card for you. So unfortunately, yes, pile number three, you are under the effect of some kind of spell, okay? And also you chose this moon card. Moon is kind of hidden things. Moon speaks of hidden things, okay? So yeah, you are under the effect of some evil spell, some manipulative spell basically. Yeah, you are, okay? Let's see guidance for you. Isolation. See, the thing I'm getting for you, the message I'm getting for you is you spell might be casted on you to separate you from somebody. Maybe love relationship or to make you lose your job. There is some kind of separation here, okay? Some kind of isolation, some kind of separation, maybe in love relationship, or it is casted on you to lose your job, to make you lose your job, or to make you lose your loving relationships, be it with anybody, okay? Just to isolate you, just to separate you from loving emotions, from success, okay? So the guidance for you is, see, you need to stay away. Basically, you need to stop blind trusting people, first of all. Stop trusting everybody blindly, because I see this is a card of Three of Swords in traditional tarot, okay? So I see that there is somebody who is near you, who you trust a lot, because this also speaks of betrayal, right? So there is somebody who you trust a lot, who is so close to you that you might never suspect them to do such thing with you. Okay, and this is the advantage they have. So just be careful, because there is somebody who is close to you who is doing this thing for sure. Because I see you do not doubt on this person. You do not doubt on this person. This person might be a family member. Somebody who stays near you. Okay, I'm getting that feeling. Because obviously they have access. They have this access to... because this person is keeping an eye on you. So this person lives nearby. I can say that. Okay. This person might be your somebody who lives in your house, or might be some of your family members. I don't know. Like relatives or somebody. Because they are quite close to you. They are quite close to you and you trust them blindly. It's like you prefer to, I would say... If you come to know that they are the people, you might be devastated. You might be devastated because they are the last people who you can doubt on. Okay. So yeah, there is somebody who is really close to you, who you trust blindly. So be careful. Just be careful. okay, just be careful of them. Do not see, sometimes we should keep our things to ourselves, okay, because we never know how can somebody be, right? The people who we trust the most betray us. So yeah, this is happening. This is happening, and definitely this person is near you, somewhere near you. Let me see. I'll pick one more card. Guides, please let me know the person who is casting this spell. Do they live nearby to this person? Are they nearby? Just let me know what pile number 3 needs to know about the person who is casting this spell on them. Because I see this person has access to everything. This is kind of a magician card, okay? So magician has all the tools. So definitely this person knows you, maybe this person comes and goes in your house daily, or is your co-worker, somebody who is really close to you. What pile number 3 needs to know about this person who is casting spell? Please, guides, give me a card. Do not blind trust, guys. Because I see the person who is casting this spell, you blind trust them. You blind trust this person. What pile number 3 needs to know about the person who is casting this spell, guides? Why did this? I'll take this back, okay? I don't know why I feel. What does pile number 3 needs to know about the person who is casting this spell on them, guys? I knew that this is about to come. This is why I took it back. New vision again. Somebody is keeping an eye on you. Somebody who is really in close proximity with you. Okay? Somebody who you value a lot, that you are ready to compromise your happiness for them, because this is the Hangman card in traditional tarot. Okay, so you are ready to suspend your happiness for this person. This is the level of your trust for them. Okay, this is the level of your trust for them. So you can know better, right? Who is the person you are ready to sacrifice your happiness for? Okay, who is this person who is in close proximity with you? You are ready to sacrifice everything, basically your happiness, everything for you, for them, and you are ready to be in a state of this suppression and depression for their happiness. That is the person who is doing this. I can say just that. Okay, so be careful, guys. Nobody deserves our sacrifice. Your happiness, you should take care of your own happiness, okay? Just, nobody is our own in this time. People who we trust, they backstab us always. People who are really close to us, they backstab us. So just keep that in mind, okay? I'm not telling you to doubt on everybody, but just be careful. Just be careful. If you remember the isolation card, yeah, this one, there is ice around this person. So you need to, a wall of ice around this person. So you need to build a wall of protection around you, and do not open it for anybody, be it anybody. There are few things which we need to keep only to ourselves, not to disclose it to anybody, no matter how close that person is. Okay, this is what I can tell you. If you need any further readings and details on this, you can book a personal reading with me. I can try to find out who this person is, okay? Just, you can contact me, because this is kind of a very, you need to be very careful, all I can say is that. Anyways, number 4, this circle, people who chose this circle, let's see. Has anybody casted a spell on number 4? Has anybody casted a spell on number 4? is pile number 4 under this effect of, okay, again these two cards, take this. Yeah, ordinariness. What was this? I just saw something. Courage, yeah, so it is kind of the same. No, I don't think you are under the effect of spell, okay? I'll include this also. You are not under the effect of some evil spell, but yeah, you are being manipulated by somebody. This is for sure. You are being, somebody is leading your path. Somebody is showing you a path. Basically, somebody is dominating over you, okay? Dominating and manipulating you. This is for sure. Not in a spell kind of way, but yeah, they are kind of brainwashing you or manipulating you, playing with your emotions. Some kind of manipulation is there, okay? Yeah. Now, let's see guidance for you. What pile number 4 needs to know? What is the guidance for pile number 4? Obviously, the guidance will be not to trust on everybody again. And trust in, believe in yourself. Do not get easily manipulated. Be strong, okay? Be strong, this courage, okay? I'll take this card back. Be strong, okay? Trust your decisions. Do not fall into the trap. Silence. Again, beyond illusion, as I was telling, trust your intuition, trust yourself, believe in yourself. See this third eye chakra. Trust your intuition, trust your instinct, believe in yourself, be headstrong. Do not fall into anybody's trap. Spend time in silence, just practice some spiritual things so that your mind is calm and you are so strong, emotionally strong, that you cannot be guided by anybody in a wrong direction. Okay, just be headstrong, guys. Because you are emotionally vulnerable, you are emotionally weak, and people are taking advantage of this thing. Somebody is taking advantage of this thing for their own selfish motive, for their own benefit. So yeah, trust your intuition, be headstrong, yeah. Spend time in nature, be calm, be silent, be calm, peaceful, and you can do some meditation or some kind of spiritual practices to make your intuitive power strong, okay? Beyond illusion. Whatever is happening is just an illusion. You should look beyond this illusion. Trust your instinct, trust your intuition. Okay, guys? Pile number 4. This was your reading. Somebody is manipulating you, but there is no spell. This circle, round and round. They are making you go round and round, okay? Manipulating, playing with your emotions. Number 5, triangle. Let's see. Is pile number 5 under the effect of some spell? Is pile number 5 under the effect of some spell? Pile number 5 under the effect of... For everybody, 2 cards are coming up. Okay, let's see this first. Rightness. Okay, this has... Oh, transformation. Yes. Yes. I'm sorry to say, unfortunately, yes. This is a... Yes, somebody is casting an evil spell on you, some dark spell on you. I'm really sorry. See, people who chose pile number 3, that is this moon and this one, triangle. Please, if you want to go into the detail, please book personal readings from me, because this is... kind of a very serious thing. This is the death card in traditional tarot, okay? And see, this rising phoenix is there, and like this person is sitting here, and yeah, so yes, and with this ripeness card, this is not something new, okay? It has ripened. Whatever this spell was, it has reached its full potential, okay? This is at its peak now. This spell is at its peak, and you might be facing consequences also, you or your family members or anybody, mostly you, because this nine number is there. This is kind of independent. This is only on you, not on anybody else, okay? So yeah, this is only for you, and this is at its peak now. This is an old spell or somebody is repeatedly casting on you, and now it is at its peak, its full potential. So this is not something new. It has already been done and you are dealing with its effect. Okay, let's see any guidance for you, because well, this is a very serious one. I don't know why I see this triangle as a pentagram. If you know what pentagram is, you can Google pentagram and spells, okay? I just don't want to go into its detail. Anyways, guidance for pile number 5. Guides, please let me know. Guidance for pile number 5. Guidance for pile number 5. This spell is already bearing fruits, guys. What they want, they have achieved that. That is what I can say. It's at its peak. Guidance for pile number 5. Change. The miser. I'll pick a few more cards for you guys. Just one more card, guys. Yeah, I had expected rebirth. Guys, please, not with me. If you don't want to book it with me, don't book it with me. But please book a session with any tarot reader, because you need detailed guidance, okay? Whoever you trust, guys, please. This is a request from my side, because you really need help. I don't want to scare you, and I've already mentioned this is a general reading. So I really hope this doesn't resonate with you, okay? But if it does, please book a session with any guide or any healer. Okay? I'm not saying book it with me, but book it with anybody who you trust on. Because I see, just a second, I'll keep it here. I don't see any much you know, you have to deal with, this is what I see. You have to go in this swirl, this round and round. Okay, you have to go in this swirl and you have to go through a lot. This is like the Ten of Swords in traditional tarot. You have to go through a lot. And then there will be, when there will be the end of this spell, then you will, then there will be a rebirth for you. Okay, not literally, metaphorically. Okay, then there'll be a rebirth for you, because right now, like, there is nothing much which you can do. You can just bear it, all I can say. If you do not take any step, if you do not take any step to change it, like consult somebody who is really experienced in this, okay, who is really experienced in this, who can remove all this and who can heal you. Unless you approach this kind of person, there is not much you can do about it, other than to bear with it, other than to wait for it to end on its own, like reach its time limit and end on its own, and then you'll start new. Okay, because this is what I'm saying. If this change has to come, it should be with somebody else who has this potential to remove this. Okay, guys. So pile number 5, this was your reading. And I really hope it doesn't resonate with you. Seriously, I really hope it doesn't resonate with you. And if it does, please consult somebody. So guys, this was your reading and this was intense one. So yeah, all I can say is be positive, be optimistic, be happy, seek help, seek guidance. Okay, let me pick a general guidance card for you, for everybody, like for all the piles, okay? A general guidance card for all the piles. Just seek help, guys. Just seek help from somebody if you need it. Guidance card for you is good qualities. What it says? The Brahmin's work is born of his nature and qualities, peacefulness, self-control, asceticism, forgiveness, honesty, learning, wisdom, and a firm faith in Supreme Lord. So basically, you all, for all the piles, focus on all the good qualities, all the good things. Do not let any negativity overpower you, because obviously it is your belief which gives power to any negative thing, okay? So just focus on good feelings, good emotions, good qualities within you, and just have extreme faith in the supreme power, in God, in universe, in the divine, okay? Because if you have extreme faith, then you might face difficulties, but nothing can harm you, okay? So this is your guidance, all the piles. Okay, and trust on your intuition. Be positive, be optimistic, be happy. Take care. Till we meet again.